Hey, this is Lady, and today I am here to do my Battle of Books 15 Readathon
I
wrap up.
decided to participate in the Readathon on day one of the Readathon. I found out about it from some other BookTubers. I went to the blog to check it out and found out it started on that day. After reading about the Readathon, I realized that it was the perfect Readathon for me because there were no like specific instructions, read a blue book, find an author with your last name, read that book. None of that. It was just basically read every day. Read as much as you can, books that you were already planning to read, and at the end, try to give a total page count of the books you read and the number of pages you read. So I went ahead and joined, and I'm so glad I did. The readathon was held from January 4th through the 10th. This readathon has been around since 2011 and it's held a few times each year. I could definitely see myself participating in the ones that's to come in the future. I think the next one is in January, and again, I'll make sure to leave the link below to the blog. I actually participated in one of the Twitter chats and several of the challenges that they had throughout the week. It was fun, and I just really enjoyed, connecting with other people, other like-minded readers. Even though we may have been reading totally different types of books, we were all reading, and I just really found joy in that. Get into the books that I read because like I said, I started on day one. I didn't have a TBR planned out. I already had some books that I was planning to read. I was already in the middle of reading a book, so this is what I On day
read. One, I finished the last 50 pages of this book here, Mary B. Morrison's Baby, You're the Best.
Monday
Monday evening, I picked up Glorious by Bernice McFadden. I've read it from Monday evening to Wednesday afternoon. On Wednesday evening, I picked up Monster by Walter Dean Myers, who wrote the actual novel, but this is the graphic novel adaptation. I started it on Wednesday evening and finished it on Thursday
On
morning.
Thursday evening after work, I picked up A Raisin in the Sun by Lorraine Hansberry and I finished it on Thursday before going to bed.
On Friday, I picked up Another Woman's Daughter. This is by Fiona Susman, I believe the name. Her name is, I hope I'm saying that correctly. I read this on Friday and I finished it on Sunday afternoon. Sunday night, I was sitting around the house and I still saw that there was time left in the readathon. So I picked up this book here, Sarah Jakes Lost and Found. I only got 7 pages in before I ended up falling asleep, and that was the end of the readathon. I am still currently reading that one. And I'm really enjoying
In
it.
all, I've read a grand total of 845 pages last week.
What? 845 pages. I can't believe it myself. I mean, it could take me a month to read that amount of pages, but because I participated in the readathon, I really didn't feel any pressure, but I just got enjoyment out of it, knowing that other people were reading and seeing all the Twitter updates and stuff. So I'm really happy with my total pages. Pat on the back for 845 pages, okay, in 7 days. Just unheard of. And then I purposely chose shorter books. So it gave me like momentum as I was finishing, so I thought that was
So,
great. I am planning to do book talks on Lost and Found, on Bernice McFadden's Glorious, and on Another Woman's Daughter. Those were my favorite three for the week. The other ones, if you want to hear more about them, we can discuss it in the comment section below. If a lot of people say they want to hear more about it, maybe I'll do a book talk on those, but I know for those three that I really enjoy, I will be doing a book talk on
if
those.
you have participated in this readathon, let me know below so I can check out your videos. Make sure to check out the blog below if you are interested in participating in future
I thank you
readathons.
all for watching. This is Lady, and I will see you in my next video. Bye.